But with the measurement scales assignment, as you may remember from statistics, there are four scales of measurement, and the scales of measurement determine the kinds of statistics you are allowed to use with your data. So it will also lead into a discussion of descriptive statistics. So, for example, nominal scales are the simplest kinds of scales. They are just records of categories. So, for example, gender, ethnicity, marital status are all nominal categories. The only thing you can do with this kind of data is calculate percentages. So you can say in a sample, the percent of your participants that were male or female, the percent that were Latino, Latinx. You cannot, it does not compare a quantity or it does not say that one category is better or higher or lower than another. Ordinal scales are different than nominal scales in that ordinal scales actually give you a rank order. They tell you that one is greater than or less than the other. So a true-false question on a test where one answer is correct and the other is false, that would be an ordinal scale because one of them is worth more points than the other. Race results or Likert scale questions on a psychological test would all be ordinal scales. If I ask you what is your favorite food, you could rank for me your top five favorite foods, and that would also be an ordinal scale. If we looked at race results in an Olympic race, that would also be an ordinal scale. Ordinal scales do not let you know the difference between a rank of one and a rank of two. So I don't know how much faster an Olympic athlete was who won a gold than a silver. I just know that one got the gold and one got the silver. So in that case, ordinal scales only allow you to use things like median scores. They allow you to do measurements of variability like range and interquartile range. They do not allow you to calculate things like means. They do not allow you to calculate things like standard deviations. You cannot actually use anything where you would calculate decimal values because we don't know how much greater or less than a rank of one is than a two. So we can only use median kinds of scales. So, in fact, if we want to use means and standard deviations and more complex kinds of analysis, we would need to rely on interval scales. Interval scales are where you have scores that are actually where the percentile differences or the decimal differences actually mean something, but there's no true zero. So many kinds of psychological tests, scores that you get on IQ tests or personality tests or self-esteem scores, those are all interval scales. So no matter how much you dislike your ex, their personality is never zero, their IQ is never zero. So in fact, interval scales don't actually have a true zero. So many kinds of psychological tests would fit that. In addition, though, you might think of temperature scales. There's only one temperature scale that actually is a true zero. All the other ones have a negative score. So if anything where a score can go negative, would be an interval scale. With an interval scale, though, you can essentially do all the kinds of statistical tests, means, medians, modes, standard deviations, interquartile ranges, and almost any kind of statistic. If you remember talking about the need and statistical tests for normal distributions and those kinds of things, interval scales and ratio scales can have that normal distribution, so you can use t-tests and ANOVA. The difference between a ratio scale and an interval scale, though, is that a ratio scale actually has a true zero. So measures of frequency, duration, distance, or income all have true zeros, right? Your distance can be zero. Your income can be zero, unfortunately. Your duration of time doing an activity can usually be zero, and your frequency of doing an activity can be zero. Any sort of measurement that you might use that use things other than psychological attributes probably are ratio scales. In practice, though, there's really no difference in interval and ratio scales in the kinds of statistics you can use. It's just in an interval scale, there's no true zero or scores can go negative, for example. Hopefully that'll help answer any questions for the measurement scale assignment.